It takes a special person to master martial arts and a special person to master chemistry. What if I told you that sometimes it's the same person? Like Professor Janis Louie. Nabil has the story.
I'm here in beautiful Salt Lake City about to meet with chemist Janis Louie, and we're gonna talk about solutions. Although, feels like this is a martial arts studio. Well, let's see what she has in store for me.
Meet Janis Louie, University of Utah chemistry professor and martial artist who is not only breaking boards, but also the stereotypes that exist around chemistry.
A lot of people think that if you are into science, you're not into sports, and vice versa, but they actually go hand in hand.
As Janis puts me through the ringer, I really start to wonder, how does this have anything to do with chemistry?
Worked up a sweat. How about you?
Me too.
Awesome, because that's the chemistry I wanted to show you today. We lose water and electrolytes from sweating, and we need to replenish them. How do you think we'd do that, Nabil?
By drinking water or a sports drink?
Yes, and those are chemistry too. Would you like to make some?
Yeah.
Awesome, let's follow me.
Chemistry!
Welcome to my Dojang laboratory, Nabil.
This looks awesome.
Well, we're gonna make some sports drinks, but first, what do you think a sports drink is, Nabil?
Water with a bunch of stuff dissolved in it? That's good for you?
Absolutely, you just described what a solution is.
A solution can be a gas, liquid, or solid. The air we breathe, the gasoline we put in cars, and even steel are all examples of solutions.
So, pop quiz, do you know what an electrolyte is?
Well, I know that they're like salts.
Absolutely. You said the magic word, salts. So they're charged molecules. That means these sports drinks conduct electricity.
What?
The positive and negative ions that make up salt create a pathway for electricity to flow. To demonstrate this, we've created a device using a battery, a Christmas light, and tin foil. Since electrolytes carry electricity, if the light glows, the solution has them.
I guess that's why they call it electrolytes.
Janis explains that you can't just dump any solid into a liquid and call it a solution. Watch what happens when we pour sand into water.
It's not dissolving, is it?
No, not at all.
No, not at all, exactly.
In order for a compound to dissolve in a liquid, you have to break the ionic bonds. In our case, we have to break sodium chloride into its individual ions, sodium, Na, and chloride, Cl. And water has the ability to do that.
Mix.
You truly look like a mad scientist, Nabil.
I really feel like one.
Do you notice any changes?
The salt's gone.
That's a solution right there. See, we can't tell that there's a solid and a liquid combined in here. It just looks like a liquid. You ready to make a sports drink?
Yes.
For my sports drink, I'm adding a cup of limeade, a cup of water, and a quarter teaspoon of magnesium chloride, which is a type of salt.
Is it time for a taste test?
Let's do it.
All right, cheers.
Cheers. That's great.
That's chemistry.
Janis has certainly made me a fan of chemistry. And she hopes to inspire other young people to believe that they too can be scientists.
Chemistry was really hard for me at first. I worked really hard, then everything just clicked. I think the young people of today should remember that it's okay to struggle and to be confident and say to themselves, I can do this. I'm smart enough. In fact, I'm more than smart enough.
Thank you so much, Janis, for having me. I had an incredible day. And you're right, chemistry is everywhere, from the moves that we make, to the sweat that we produce, to the drinks that we drink. I mean, I kind of don't want to leave. Can I just stay here and break some more boards? I mean, bonds?
Absolutely. In fact, why don't we go break some boards right now?
Let's do it.
Yeah.
Do you love videos like this? Or how about this? Well, I have like a million more videos I want you to see. Go subscribe and hit that notification bell so you don't miss out on exclusive videos like this one.